At the other end of the Home Office is a complex that not everybody knows about. Under this 15-foot concrete slab, reinforced with railway lines, there still exist the old War Cabinet rooms. It was from this room that Winston and his cabinet ran the whole war, and the room has never been dismantled. Of this chair, Winston said, "If the invasion takes place, that's where I shall sit, in that chair, and I'll sit there until either the Germans are driven back or they carry me out dead." His bedroom, where he did so much of his work, and from which most of his wartime broadcasts were made over direct line to the BBC. There was only one mic, so the announcer had to sit on Winston's lap to introduce him. That I should like to have seen. This is not, as you might think, the loo. It was Winston's way of camouflaging the room from which he used to speak on the transatlantic scrambler telephone to President Roosevelt. Strictly speaking, we've now come to the end of Whitehall, because the street on the right is Parliament Street, and like Whitehall at the other end, I'm afraid a little bit tatty. However, there's talk of pulling all that bit there down and replacing it with a huge new building to accommodate members of Parliament and their secretaries. And this, of course, the Cenotaph, the centre of so many ceremonial activities in Whitehall, and from a Greek word, two Greek words, empty tomb. Now, some people think that the ceremony is becoming a bit empty too. I don't agree, but there's no getting away from the fact that fewer people turn up for the ceremony and fewer people take off their hats when passing the cenotaph. I don't think this is just because people don't wear hats nowadays. I think because the ceremony may be losing its meaning, or maybe just the meaning is changing, like so much else is changing in Whitehall.